Madam Secretary, I know we all wish that this had never happened, so this hearing would never have had to happen, but it's good. We're glad to see you here and wish you all the best. And secondarily, I want to share the sentiments of my other colleagues of tremendous respect for the hard work and service that you've put in on behalf of our country, both as a member of this chamber and then obviously now in the role that you have. One of the things that I'm most interested in exploring with you today a little bit is how information flows within the State Department, and in particular in hindsight, looking forward, how we can prevent some of this happening. And so I was curious about a number of things. First of all, were you ever asked to participate in any sort of internal or interagency meeting before this attack with regard to the deteriorating security situation in Libya?
Well, Senator, you know, again, I appreciate your kind words, you know, I reiterate my taking responsibility. And as I have already said, with specific security requests, they didn't come to me. I had no knowledge of them. With regard to the situation in Libya, not just eastern Libya, across Libya, there were a number of conversations and meetings to try to see what we could do while Libya went through this transition from transitional government to interim government to elections, to try to get in there and help them with security, because it was clear that was going to be one of their highest needs once they finally got stabilized. So, you know, there were a number of meetings, and I personally, you know, I went to Libya in October of 2011. I spoke with the then leadership. I met with them in international settings. We sent teams out, both civilian and military experts, to try to help them. Until recently, while they were going through their transitions, it was a very difficult conversation because they didn't have, you know, the authority they thought. But now we're beginning, and we have a long list of ways that we're trying to help improve security in Libya.
For example, the October 2011 meeting, at that meeting, did this issue come up with regards to the inability of the Libyan government to protect our diplomatic institutions? Did that issue come up at all in that conversation?
Well, we obviously talked a great deal about the deteriorating threat environment in Libya. One of the reasons we had our own people on the ground and why we were looking to try to figure out how to better protect Benghazi and how to have understandings with those in the annex is because it's a host country responsibility, but you know, they were not in a position to do what we would expect from an organized country. But they did have the militias, and the, you know, the February 17th Brigade had proven to be responsive in the past, prior to 9/11. Other militias in Tripoli had proven to be responsive. You know, when I landed in Tripoli, I was met by the Zintan militia. That was the welcome I had. All these guys dressed completely in black, holding their automatic weapons, that was my welcoming party. So we knew that we were piecing together what a host nation was not yet able to do.
Right. But and then there was another meeting on March 2012. So just to be clear, in October 2011, then again in March of 2012, I believe that was here with the Prime Minister, and neither one of these meetings was there a specific conversation between you and them with regards to concerns that we had, that not just the deteriorating security situation, but the inability of them as a host country to meet their obligations to provide security.
Of course.
There was a conversation.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, this was a constant conversation, Senator. And what I found with the Libyans was willingness, but not capacity. You know, in Tunisia, as I told you, they had capacity, but I had to call and just tell them we had to get that capacity out there. Because, you know, they're still trying to figure out how to be a state without being a security state. With Cairo, we had to call and tell the Egyptians, get your people out there. So with Libya, it was different. The Libyans were very responsive, very willing, but no levers to pull. And what we've been trying to do, and, you know, we need your help to help us pay for what we're trying to do. We are trying to help them build a decent security force, to try to rein in the militias as best they can. So this was a constant conversation.
Before the attack in Benghazi, what had we done specifically to help them build their security capacities?
Well, there's a long list, and I'll be happy to provide that to you, because it is filled with you know, training, with equipment, with the kind of planning that they had not done before. And I'd be happy to send you the detail on that, Senator.